Hey everyone, thank you so much for watching and subscribing my channel. This is Gayatri. Welcome you all to BioSchool. In the last video, we have discussed about the formation of bulba in C. elegans, where we have seen how the anchor shell plays an important role in the bulba formation. In today's session, it is about the formation of anchor cell, and we'll solve the question related to this topic. So please be with me till the end of the video. Thank you. Today we'll see anchor cell and its formation in C. elegans. We know the C. elegans are the small free living soil nematodes, commonly known as the roundworms, and it is an important model organism in the developmental biology. In their early development, they are the male and the gonad produce the sperm, which is stored in the spermatheca for later use. As they grow older, they develop the ovaries and the egg roll through the region of the sperm storage and are fertilized inside the nematode and passed out of the body through the bulba. Now we'll see what is the anchor shell. Anchor shell is the cell that connect the bulbal precursor cells with the overlying gonads, that is known as the anchor cells. And this anchor shell, it secretes the protein. This protein is known as the LIN3 protein. The formation of anchor shell, it is mediated by LIN12 in C. elegans, which is homologous to the Notch gene. So the formation of anchor shell, it is mediated by Notch delta signaling pathway, and we will see how it is mediated. The wild C. elegans hermaphrodite has the two adjacent cells. Okay, this is one cell, and this cell is named as the J1PPP cell. And another cell is known as the J4AAA. And both the cells have the potential to become the anchor cell. But they interact in such a manner that one of the cell, it becomes the anchor cell, and the another cell that becomes the uterine precursor cell. Okay, I just represented as UP. So one cell, it will become the anchor cell, whereas the other cell, it will become the precursor for the uterine tissue. If there is a loss of function of LIN12 mutant, then it will result in the formation of anchor cell. This is very important. Okay, LIN12 protein is play important role in the formation of anchor cell. If there is a loss of function in LIN12 mutant, then both the adjacent cell, they will become the anchor cell, whereas the gain of function of mutation of both the cell, they become the uterine precursor cell. So from here we concluded that the LIN12 gene needed to function only in that cell that is destined to become the uterine precursor cells. So the uterine precursor cells has the LIN12 gene. Okay, so see here, this is the two adjacent cells. It is present in the adult wild type C. elegans. Okay. Originally, both the cell, they synthesize the signal. This the signal molecule. Okay. And this is represented by the receptor. Okay. The signal is represented by the dark violet color, whereas this is the signal molecule, which is represented like this. And the receptor molecule is presented like this. So initially, or originally, the two cells synthesize both the signal for the uterine differentiation. Okay, the signal molecule is known as the LAG2 protein. Signal molecule is known as the LAG2 protein, which is homologous to delta. Which is homologous to delta. As I told you before, that the anchor cell formation is mediated by the delta non-signaling pathway, and it is the Justacran signaling pathway, where the two cells are the physically in contact with each other, and the receptor molecule is known as the LIN12. Receptor is known as the LIN12, which is homologous to Notch. So delta is the signal and Notch is the receptor. So during the particular time in the larval development, what will happen? By chance, one of the cell secrete the more LAG2. Okay, so here you can see that this cell secretes the more LAG2. More LAG2 signaling molecule. By secreting the more LAG2, it causes its neighbor to cease its the production. Okay, and the neighboring cell, it increases the production of LIN12. Neighboring cell, it produces the more LIN12. Okay, this will produce the more LAG2, and the neighboring cell, it produces the more LIN12. So the cell that secrete the more LAG2, that becomes the gonadal anchor cell. This cell, it secrete the more the LAG2 protein, so it becomes the anchor cell. While the cell receiving the signal through the LIN12 protein, it receiving the signal through the LIN12 protein, and it differentiated into ventral uterine precursor cells. So what we concluded? We concluded here that the cell, okay, and this cell, it is considered, it is the Z1 PPP cell, and it is the Z4 AAA cell. These two cells are the adjacent cells, and initially both the cells, they produce the signal molecule LAG2 and the LIN12, that is the receptor. But at one stage in the early development, what will happen? The one of the cell, it will start to secrete the more the signaling molecule, that is the LAG2, that result in the formation of the anchor cell. And by secreting the LAG2, it sees the neighboring cells production of the LAG2. The neighboring cell start to synthesize more LIN12, and the LIN12, it will lead to formation of the uterine precursor cells. And the formation of the anchor cell, it is mediated by the delta notch signaling pathway. If there is a loss of function of the LIN12 mutant, then the both the cell, it will become the anchor cell. If there is a gain of function of mutation of LIN12, then the both the cell become the uterine precursor cells. Only these things you have to remember. Let's see the previous year question. Following statements were made regarding vulval development in C. elegans. The 6 vulval precursor cells are influenced by anchor cell to form an equivalence group. Yes. Okay. If you have seen the last video on the vulva development in C. elegans, then in the precursor cells, we have discussed on this in our previous video, that is on the vulva development in C. elegans. If you have missed that video, then you will get the link in the description box. Please do watch. In the loss of function of LIN12 mutant, both the cell becomes anchor cell, not the uterine tissue. So this one is the wrong answer. If anchor cell is destroyed in the early development, all the 6 vulvar precursor cells divide once and contribute to the formation of hypodermal cells. Yes, this is right. Anchor cells or the uterine precursor decision is due to notch delta mediated mechanism of restricting adjacent cell fates. Yes, this is right. Paracrine factors secreted by anchor cell directly activate the notch delta pathway. No. Which of the following options represent the combination of correct statement? That is option 1, 3 and 4. That is option A is the correct answer. Thank you so much for watching the video till the end, and I'm sure that this video will definitely help you in your preparation. If you like this video, then share and don't forget to subscribe my channel. Bye bye. See you in the next video.